Thank you, Sudeshji, and a very good evening to everybody. As all of you know, because this is a very prestigious gathering where very select people are invited to, the 3AAAI Lifetime Achievement Award is probably one of the most coveted and most one of the biggest honors that in the Indian advertising industry anybody gets. It has very, I have to tell you that there is a committee that looks into in the selection process, but it has some very well set out processes and criteria based upon which the winner is selected, the recipient of the award is selected. Please allow me to read out some of the criteria so you'll understand what goes into winning an award like this. The eligibility criteria, amongst others, for the nominee is that the person should have at least 25 years plus as practitioner of advertising and must have been or should be at top management positions, should be or continue to be an active participant in industry bodies and should have made significant contribution in shaping industry priorities, should individually be known for his or her integrity, ethical practice, leadership qualities, should have contributed to his company or companies by growth, by innovative thinking, and by taking them in newer directions, should have been involved in projects of social consequence, which and be seen as a role model for the industry at large, and should really be seen as an industry veteran. Allow me the honor of reading some of the past recipients of this award to give you the sense of people who've got it. Some of them are in this room. Mr. Subhash Ghosal was the first recipient, followed by Mr. Bal Munkar, Mr. K. Kurian, Mr. S. R. Iyer, Mr. Alec Padamsi, Mr. Sylvester Dekuna, Mr. M. K. Khanna, Mr. Subroto Sen Gupta, Mr. Ravi Gupta, who actually got it posthumously, Mr. R. K. Swami, Mr. Krishnamurti, Mohammed Khan, Mr. Jerson Dekuna, Walter Saldana, Arun Nanda, Prem Mehta, Gautam Rakshit, Ranjan Kapoor, Sam Balsara, Piyush Pandey, Anil Kapoor, Ramesh Narayan, Mr. Bobby Sister, Sundar Swami, and Rhoda Mehta, who was last year's recipient. So as you can see, it's a very illustrious roll call, so to speak. And the selection committee, which met this year to do it. So let me tell you a little bit about the selection process. All the members of 3AAAI, including the executive committee as well as the others, are requested to send in their nominations. The selection committee comprised this year of four past presidents, two of whom themselves were recipients of this award, and a few others. So we had on this committee Sam Balsara, Sundar Swami, Nakul Chopra, who's past president just half an hour ago or something, and Mr. Ambi Parmeshwaran, Mr. Jaideep Gandhi, and I had the privilege of chairing this committee this year. And when a lot of nominations obviously come in, and each person who's nominated, because these nominations are done by very, very senior people in the industry, industry leaders, so each person who's nominated is a stalwart by himself or herself. And from the longer list, the committee then draws it down to a short list, usually of three names. And I tell you, I mean, when you see those names, when you hear those names, you feel so small because you see how much these people have done and how much of veterans they have been. This year, when all the names came in, each one of them were very worthy of receiving the award, but unanimously, one name that stood out, which the committee decided upon, was that of Mr. Rm Sehgal. So please give him a very big hand. I'm not even going to attempt to introduce Mr. Sehgal. I'll say a few things about him, but before I do that, there is an aside which I just told him about half an hour ago, which I'm sure he didn't remember. One of the poor judgments I think he might have made in his career was he once offered me a job. So, and the highlight to me was that the after the first round, the second interview was with Saida and him, and it was in Sea Lounge in Taj. And you know, when you're a senior AE or an account manager or whatever, it's a big deal that you're going to Sea Lounge for the interview. This was for the position in Delhi, so he actually gave me an air ticket to go to Delhi to meet the branch manager over there. So in a moment of weakness, he did that, but it was a highlight which I remember. And even on that day, I could see that how, I mean, you know, there's some things in people that don't change. The manner in which he conducted himself, there was a lot to learn from it. His gentleness, his thoroughness, and just the way that he, I think we miss that in advertising today. Right, it almost seems like over the years there is something that we have lost, and I tell you, Mr. Sehgal really epitomizes that in my mind as I look back. He needs no introduction, but I think what he will always be known for is that he attempted to build what was called a second agency, which no agency group had really been successful in doing, and might I add, very few even thereafter have been as successful in doing as he did, because Contract started off, as all of you know, as an offshoot from JWT, and in its own time, he was seconded from HTA, which is now JWT, and with a handful of people from the bigger brother, as it was called, he went up and he went on to set up this agency, which then became legendary. Through the entire decade of 90s, Contract was acknowledged not only as a creative powerhouse, but also as a thinking agency. Not once, but three times it was adjudged Agency of the Year at the Ad Club Awards. And for a small upcoming agency to win that against the stalwarts that had been there for perhaps 50, 60, 70 years before that was something which was no mean feat. And it was under his pioneering leadership that Contract set up several different businesses, like a direct marketing division called Contract Direct, which later on became iContract, Strategic Design, Identity Units, Design Sutra, etc. And this, mind you, was in early 90s, well before the trend had caught on with the other agencies. Another one of his big initiatives that Contract took under his leadership, which was lauded by the industry, was the Windows Training Program, which along with Subhash Ghoshal, Professor Subrato Sengupta, and of course Ram, young candidates, raw talent, with highly talented talent, was put through 3 months of rigorous classroom program, etc. And many of them went on to become industry leaders and occupy very, very significant positions and influence our industry in a big way. While his stint in Contract is well remembered, one of the things that some of the senior members of 3AAAI, including our immediate past president, when he spoke about it, I think what is lesser known is that even in JWT's HTA's Delhi branch was one of the biggest branches in the world, I'm told, one of the biggest agencies, and it was him who actually set it up and moved it up to that pedestal and took it up. So it's not just one Contract, but it's a consistent track record even before that. And I think it is his upbringing in the ashram at Pondicherry, and he continues to be involved with social work there, that made him really spiritual. His leadership at Contract made him spirited. And I think it was under him that a startup agency, you know, well before the startups era came into being, became such an agile, liberated leader in the industry in many ways. And it would be fair to say that it was Ram Sehgal who made Contract so alive. With this, ladies and gentlemen, please give a big hand to our 3AAAI Lifetime Achievement Award winner for 2018.